our next video lecture module on the industrial development. Okay, so we may not go that much detailed into some of the topics. I just, you know, briefly explain so that, you know, when you read from the PDF, whatever important points you miss out, you can identify here. That is the main idea of this video lectures here. Okay, so first one is Z scheme. What is the Z scheme? G mean zero, D mean defect, zero defect scheme. Okay, so here, you know, it is mainly emphasizing on the manufacturing. So many times we will make fun of the Chinese product. Whenever some product is not working properly, then we will say that is it from China, because China quality, Chinese product quality is not that much high. Okay, so that is why here under the Make in India, we are mainly emphasizing on the zero defects and zero effect. Okay, that means we are trying to emphasize on the quality. So here government is key to promote the quality in the manufacturing, especially in the manufacturing. See, we need to tap the manufacturing sector, it yet to develop in our country. Why? Because, you know, the employability, the capacity or potential of employability in the manufacturing is very, very high compared to the service sector. Okay, this is the second stage in the traditional economics. So here, quality standards in the works for key sector, we will select some of the key sectors and you concentrate the quality there. And then standards creation to complement the Make in India. Okay, and then there are 10 products in each 25 focus sector of the scheme should be, you know, identified to concentrate quality development. And who will implement this? Bureau of Indian Standards to devise these norms. Okay, and here see here what is happening. For example, if you take the micro, small and medium enterprises, MSME, you know, almost 22,000 companies are registered for this scheme. What is that? Zero defect and zero effect. And see, this is mainly for producing the high quality manufacturing product and with a minimum negative impact. So that what happens? The product will gain the international importance and then we can increase the export. That is the main objective here. So here, under the scheme, we need to develop an ecosystem for the zero defects manufacturing in a MSME. See, most of the times here, if you look at this micro, small and medium enterprises, their resources are constrained. Okay, unlike the very big corporations or organizations, okay, industries. So here, you might have learned so many quality techniques like total quality management, Six Sigma, and so many other lean manufacturing. So you develop some ecosystem. Ecosystem means, you know, you develop government under the scheme, they will develop what are the procedures that you need to follow to reduce the defects. Okay, then these fellows can avail those procedures and promote the adaptation of quality tools, systems and energy efficient manufacturing, which are already adopted by the, you know, big industries. And enable means they will promote, give the suggestions and then enable means, you know, they will make sure that these required technology will come at a lesser cost to them. Otherwise they can, you know, use like a cloud, in a cloud platform, they will keep in some cloud, government enabled cloud platform, and anyone can access this by paying the minimal amount. Okay, and encourage the MSME to constantly upgrade their quality standards in products and the processes. Okay, and you know, all other points are related to like that only. In the examination, whichever point is, you know, convincing, that can be chosen for the option here. For example, if you go through here, drive manufacturing with the adoption of zero defect production processes. Okay, here, and then support Make in India campaign, develop professionals in the area of JID manufacturing under certification. See, JID manufacturing means it is mainly emphasizing on the Six Sigma and quality improvement. So you develop the professionals who will understand these concepts. Okay, and there are presently 50 parameters for a Z rating. Okay, So, for example, you have a company and you are producing some products, and to get this generating, these 50 parameters should be passed. Apart from that, you know, there are some 25 additional parameters also, especially for the defense rating. Okay, and then MSME are provided financial assistance for these activities to carry out, okay, to get the JED certification. And the Quality Council of India has been appointed as the nodal monitoring and the implementing unit for the implementation of JET. Okay, so here you need to observe here, Quality Council of India, it is different from the Bureau of Indian Standard. That is, you know, trying to here, Bureau of India Standard trying to devise the norms and procedures here. Okay, and here it is a monitoring agency. Okay, so next one is employment generation in MSME sector. See here, there is always a lot of emphasis on the MSME sector, especially in India. Why is that so? Because most of the people are employed in under this MSME. Okay, so many broad range of industries comes here. So here, under the Pradhan Mantri Employment Guarantee Program, Pradhan Mantri Employment Guarantee Program, okay. So these are the numbers given, the estimation generation of the employment, okay. But actually, it should be more than this. For example, in 2018 and 19, only 5.87 lakhs are employed in this sector. But it should be much more higher than this to absorb the present unemployment and the available youth. Okay. So here, to increase the employment, there are different schemes, you know, that is mainly targeting the MSME. Why? Because most of the people are, you know, employed in this MSME. So what is that Pradhan Mantri Employment Guarantee Generation Program? Okay, under this, you know, there are some economic intensive and as well as the training programs, and the micro and small enterprise cluster development program. Cluster means, you know, they will identify some of the, you know, industries, and then they will try to focus, you know, they develop a particular region for those industries. And a scheme for promotion of MSME Northeastern region and Sikkim. So you identify what are the available talents that are there in the Northeast and then Sikkim. For example, bamboo industry is one such example, or bee industry is one such example, or most of the Northeastern people, you know, they can speak very good English. So you can set up some BPOs there itself. So like that, you identify something and then develop, okay, there. And tool rooms and technology centers. Okay, when you start up the small industry, then you need to make sure that they are access to the tool rooms and then technologies there. And then scheme for fund generation and traditional industries, procurement and marketing support scheme. Okay, most of the time they may not find the marketing, okay, lucrative marketing. Okay, if they readily find the marketing, then more and more people will show interest in that, then cultivate that particular, you know, industry. And skill development here, and here credit guarantee scheme for micro and small enterprises. That means whenever they need some loans to start up that, so they can get this. So Mudra is one such example here. We have seen this. Okay, and then next one is credit linked capital subsidy and a technology upgradation scheme. For example, you know, what is the meaning of that credit linked? For example, you don't have some machinery here for your industry, and you are importing or you are buying some machinery, so that is nothing but capital here in the industry. So whenever you are buying that, then you know, approximately some 15% of the upfront discount will be given by the government when you are purchasing that. Upfront means when you are buying itself, they will give. It's not like first you buy and then we will provide you produce the certificate so that we will give after that. Like, it's not like that. It is upfront. Okay, so all these schemes are mainly targeting the EMS is okay. And next one is Agri AZ Pro project. Okay. So see, still government in India, you know, most of the people are still employed in the agriculture. Still agriculture. And these days, if you see the trend, actually what is happening, still in the agriculture, whoever is illiterate, they only, you know, mostly concentrated in the agriculture. And the people whoever are completing the degree, they are not treating this agriculture as a proper profession. Okay. They are not treating this as a proper profession. Because of that, what is happening? Government is implementing so many, schemes, but those are not reaching these people. We will see why it is not reaching. For example, here, what happened? The government launched this Green AZ project. What is the meaning of that? Green AZ. The name itself, we have the green. Green means here, we need to trying to transform the Indian agriculture for global environmental benefits. Environmental benefits, that means it should not jeopardize the environment and conservation of critical biodiversity and forest landscapes. Okay, what is the critical biodiversity? For example, here, what is happening? So first we will see what is the meaning of what is the main purpose of this project and who is developing this. This is the Global Environment Facility. This is a very much important organization. Okay, so here the main aim is, you know, when you are doing the Indian agriculture, you should not take away the biodiversity of that particular region, and it should not affect the environment. How it is affecting the environment? You are using so many pesticides and then chemicals in your field. Then automatically after the runoff from the water, what is happening? It is affecting not only your surroundings, but it is through the water runoff, it is affecting even far away places also. Okay, and then it is degrading the excessive use of the fertilizers, degrading the land also there. Especially if you consider, the Punjab and then Haryana, what happened? After the green revolution, there is a excessive farming in the Punjab and Haryana. Okay, very very intensive farming. Okay. So intensive irrigation, because of that, what happened? They started using very, very high amount of fertilizers. Why? Because the fertilizers are, hugely discounted from the subsidized from the government. Now, because of that, what is happening? After some time, all these minerals and everything is, leaching into the lower layers of the earth, and then they are making the land, over the period, they are making that, they are depriving the, the benefits of the land. Okay. So, here, what's about the project? The project would be implemented in collaboration with the Food and Agriculture Organization. Generally, presently, it is implemented in the Madhya Pradesh, Mizoram, Odisha, Rajasthan, and Uttarakhand. Okay. So if you look at these places, this Chambal landscape is different landscape. Okay, because of this land revenants and some other totally unusual geographical topography. And then if you see this Odisha Simulpal landscape, is one of the biodiversity hot spots in India. And Rajasthan is like a desert and near desert. And then Uttarakhand also Karbet Rajaji landscape. This is also, comes under a national park and as well as the biodiversity. That means here, if you look at these places where they have selected these in implementation of the project, these places are having some particular importance. Okay, because of these agriculture, these landscapes shouldn't be affected. That is why they are trying to implement there. Once if it is successful there, then they will automatically spread to the other places. Okay. The project envisages integrated biodiversity, climate change, and sustainable land management objectives. Always they use these terms, which we may be confusing. They integrate biodiversity. What is the biodiversity? That means when you are choosing something, you should not take away the biodiversity in that particular place. Okay, one such example is, for example, before some 10 to 15 years ago, there are different types of rice, different types of rice seeds. Okay, different types of rice varieties are there. Okay, but presently, what happened after the advent of this green revolution? They started introducing the high yield rice varieties. Because of that, what happened? The biodiversity, that means different types of rice varieties, diminished, and everyone is using the same type of high yield variety here. That means the biodiversity is reduced. Even though you are thinking that the biodiversity is reduced only in the rice, automatically it will affect the surrounding place also. Okay, and then climate change and sustainable land. Sustainable land means, because of the use of the farming technology or the methods, the land shouldn't become, barren. Okay, that means you should not use the fertilizers and the pesticide without any, scientific backup. Okay. So, here, what is the GEF, Global Environment Fund? It is an international partnership. It is not only with the government, it is also international institutions. So, the question may be asked, who are the main partners in the GEF? It is the government of 183 countries, international institutions, what is the meaning of international institutions? The WTO, World Bank, all these are international institutions, and civil society, okay, and then private sector, everyone is a part of this. Okay, so it is established on the eve of Rio Earth Summit. Earth Summit is very, very important. That time only, first time they started emphasizing on the different terms. What is that? Biodiversity, climate change. Okay. All these things came only during this meeting. So, it helps to tackle the pressing environment problems. Help means they will give the guidance and then they will provide the solutions, they will carry out the research there in that particular area, what is really happening, how to avoid that. And not only from the guidance and then suggestions, they also fund such projects which will increase the environmental effect. Increase the, preserve the environment, okay, especially in the developing countries, they will fund it, okay. So, but again, this funding is not entirely free, there are some restrictions and all, so that we are not going into detail here. See, one more thing is hiring app for farmers, hiring app. See, the farmers are, most of the farmers in India are not educated and they don't know how to use the smartphone, but how they use these app. That is what the main difference between other countries, developed countries, and India is. People who have completed degree here, is they are thinking that they are not suitable for farming. They are only for meant for other jobs, But here, in this particular app, what is the main purpose of this app? Farmers will now be able to hire farm machineries, including the tractors. Okay, some other whatever you need for the farming, you can take this, rice cutters, and then grain crushers, all these farm equipment you can hire by using this app. You download this app, install, and then you can hire this. Okay, as Ola, Uber, taxis, instead of buying the taxi car, you can hire this. In the same way, you can hire using this. So it is having a once if you have the app, you can always have the data collection. these days the data collection and then data business is a thriving one. So for example, if you take the Ola or Uber or any other Zomato or Swiggy, what happened? Always there are big data scientists there. They analyze the pattern of the, you know, consumers. Okay, and they will see where exactly they need to improve and everything. So here, this app not only providing the equipment to the, you know, farmers, it also track the usage of the new technology, how people are using, how many people are using, okay, where exactly people are not using the technology. These are all you can track this, okay, from the user data. So, for example, here, Happy Seeder. Happy Seeder is one such machine that will prevent the stubble burning that causes the air pollution. What is the meaning of that Happy Seeder? When the crop, you know, at the time of crop harvesting means, you know, at the final stage, okay. Generally, if you take the rice, they will cut the rice and then they will collect that and then they will separate the grain by using some force or whatever, some means, okay. And after that, you know, so much of, the rice plant will be left over in the field itself, okay. So then before they again come for the, you know, new season, they will burn this. Because of this burning, okay, all that, because of the burning and then planetary wind system, it is all being carried into the Delhi. That is what happening, Delhi air pollution most of the time, okay. But if you use the Happy Seeder, then what happened? It is crushing and making it as a powder. Everything, the rice plant also being made into the powder, and then it will be, you know, left there in the field itself. And it is not only reducing this, burning problem, it is also providing some required nutrients to the land, okay, field. And sometimes we use the solar dryers. For example, many people are using the solar dryer. What is the meaning of the solar dryer? Solar dryers are like it will help the farmer to, you know, heat the product, okay. If it is a wet, then it will heat it and then they can immediately, readily can sell that, okay. So, solar dryer again based on the solar system, okay. So, it will observe these, like, oh, how many people are using, and if someone wants these, you know, they can hire this, okay. For example, here, this is the main purpose of the app. So these are all, you know, see here, you can see the tractor, here a tractor, you can see all the farm related equipment, okay. You can see in the app and then you can book for 1 day or 2 days, something like that. And here, this is the seeder, okay, Happy Seeder. Happy Seeder, what is happening? It is crushing everything here itself. And then this is a solar dryer. So about the customer hiring center. Customer hiring centers are there. Okay, generally it is useful for the marginal farmers. Who are marginal farmers? Who is having the land holding less than the 2 hectares of the land? Okay, though they, by which of their economic conditions they are unable to own the farm machinery. Okay, it is not, you know, economically viable for them to buy the tractor and big equipment. If they have very, very, huge land, then they can buy. So, in such cases, they can make use of these hiring centers and then order the required farm equipment. And ideally, these CHCs should locate within the radius of 5 to 7 kilometers of the land holding. Then it will be easier. Okay, and this will reduce the transport cost and the time of transport of agriculture machinery also. Okay, but see, these very few people know all these technologies. For example, I know I am also from a farming background. So when I go to my home, no one knows all this. If someone is bringing some machinery, then only they come to know. They don't use the technology. It is all based on the, you know, mouth word. Why? Because no one is interested in, educated people, no one is interested in farming. That is the problem. And a promotion of e-agriculture. This is also technology-based initiative. So, it is also to promote the technology in the agriculture sector. Okay, ICAR. ICAR is the Indian Council of Agriculture Research. It established Krishi Vigyan Kendra. Krishi mean, you know, farming or irrigation. Krishi Vigyan mean knowledge. Kendras mean centers. Irrigation knowledge center or farming, agriculture. Krishi mean, otherwise you can call agriculture knowledge centers. Okay, they established 715 in the country, mandated with the technology assessment and demonstration for its application and capacity development. Okay, see, previously, you know, there were very, very few centers, but now it is, you know, very happy to see that they established almost 715 centers. Initially, it was unthinkable to, you know, establish these. I will tell what is really happening. For example, what is the difference between our Indian agriculture system and then American? For example, in US, what is happening? In US, most of the farmers, they stay in the cities itself. Okay, they stay in the city and the land holding is very, very huge there, land holding. But still, they are able to do very good farming. How they are doing that? Because they use, you know, the technology. So, first what happened, whenever they want to go for some particular type of a crop, let's say sugarcane. Okay, sugarcane. Then, otherwise maize. Okay, they want to do some maize farming there. Then what happened? They will first take the soil there. Soil there and then soil sample will be sent to the some research center or the institutions there. Then they will get the report from the soil. Based on that report, you know, they will mix some nutrients in the land and they use only that particular nutrients. And then they will go for this plantation, maize plantation. And then what happens, you know, periodically they will get all environmental and then environmental and natural disaster alerts also. Okay, so based on that they will take corrective actions and even the pest control also through the technology also. In India, especially in rural areas, what happens if some fellow is using the new pesticide without realizing its effect, side effects, or it's a real effect, you know, some fellow uses some new pesticide and the surrounding neighbor fellow, what they do, they also bring the new pesticide, okay, without knowing anything. They don't take any advice from anyone. They simply choose by themselves, okay. But here in case of US, it is not like that, you know. These research institute or some technical institute only or the organization will suggest you use this one for this type of pest. Then they will use only that particular test. Okay. So, it's all based on the technology here. But whereas here, it is not based on the technology. So, here also we want to implement the same type of a procedure. That is why here irrigation or agriculture knowledge center. So, in this, you know, they are establishing these many centers. Okay. So, here agro advisors are given to the farmers through various service providers and the M Kisan portal. We have one portal also, M Kisan portal. You go to their portal and there are so much of information. And apart from that portal, you know, some SMS also will be sent, you know, regularly to your phone. So, what is there in the M Kisan portal? It will provide the web-based mobile advisory to the farms. Okay, you download the portal and you register your mobile and then you will enter the details like which type of farming you are doing and all relevant data you enter there. Then you regularly you will get the advisories. Okay, so it is from the research institutes and then agricultural universities. Okay. And it is not only related to the farm related, it is also weather related and then market related, okay, and various technologies and various farm operations. Market also very much important. For example, you need to know the nearby markets and you need to know which market is offering how much price. All these you need to know, okay, everything will be done through this. And then government also using the satellite data and geographical information system. using the GIS technology. Okay, so that it will estimate the crop production estimation, horticulture inventory, suitability of site, everything they can do by using the technology these days. Okay, and apart from this, government came up with some other schemes like National Agriculture Market, e-market. Generally, you know, when you produce something, you cannot arbitrarily go and sell any, you know, wherever you want. You know, here the it is you know, there are so many middlemen in the selling the produce, especially agriculture produce here. So we have a, you know, state government controlled agricultural market. Okay, so here what is happening, you know, here we instead of depending on the middlemen, using this app, okay, scheme, there is a transparent discovery of the remunerative prices, whichever is suitable to you. Okay, online bidding, you can go for the online bidding, whoever give more money to you, then you can give your produce to them. And then there is one more scheme, age mark net. What is that? Age for agriculturer, MARK means marketing market, agricultural marketing network portal. Okay, so that means here it is a information about the setting up of maintaining the connectivity with the market. See, there are, for example, in a state there are so many markets, so you connect each and every market, and then in the real time you can display the cost of various products in a different markets. Okay, and next one is zero budget farming. Sometimes we might have heard in the news these days like a zero budget politics also. Here, zero budget farming. What is the zero budget? That means you are not spending anything here. Zero budget natural farming means, you know, it is a method applied to the farming where the cost of growing and harvesting plants is zero here. Okay, so how it is done then? Generally, most of the cost incurred in the farming, is because of what? Because of the pesticide. Okay, because of the pesticides, and then we use so many unnecessary artificial things. So here what is happening, biological pesticide we use instead of the chemical based pesticide, and they use the, for you know, pesticides, and another thing we use is fertilizers instead of artificial fertilizers. We use the earthworms, cow dung, urine, plants, human excreta, and such biological fertilizers we will use for this. Okay, and it will reduce the farmers' investment. Why? Because these are all free, and then it is also protect the soil degradation, soil from the degradation. And electricity also very much less is required for such things. Okay, and here Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. Okay, these words are these are all Hindi words. So Krishi Vikas means, you know, Krishi irrigation, Vikas means, you know, development Yojana scheme. Okay, so here they started some experiments, you know, in the Modipuram, Pantnagar, Ludhiana, Kurukshetra. You don't need to remember this, but you know some idea what is the zero budget farming. In the same way, zero budget politics. And this one is important again, you remember this. Rice fortification. What is the meaning of the fortification? Okay, this is also sometimes called as the golden rice. Golden rice. It looks like a golden color. It is in the golden color. So here, Niti Aayog seeks a creation of roadmap by Department of Food and Public Distribution for taking the rice fortification, you know, pilot scheme in Pan India. What is the fortification here? Fortification is the practice of deliberately increasing the content of essential micronutrients. What is the micronutrients? Micronutrients are vitamins, you know, nutrients are vitamins, minerals. Okay, So that means here what is happening? Rice, if you take rice, most of the people in India, if you take in India or if you take entire world, you know, almost 3 billion people are eating the rice only. It is a staple food for them. Okay, even in India, most of the people are eating rice, especially in South India. So what is happening in the rice? Rice is mainly rich in the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates, and here, you know, there are no, you know, vitamins or even proteins also very less here. Okay. So to increase this, what happens? And most of the time, what is happening, if in your food there is no micronutrients like a vitamin A, deficiency of vitamin A will lead to the, you know, mental and then blindness also. You know, mental capacity will be decreased here. And vitamin B1, vitamin B12, folic acid, iron, zinc, all these are very much important for the healthy growth of the body and then mental capacity. Okay. So in the fortified rice, we will use some, you know, genetic engineering. By using that, we will try to introduce some traces of this. So that what happened, you know, along with the carbohydrates, these traces also will be there in the rice. Okay. Because of these traces, what happened? The color of these rice will change and they look like a golden color. That is why it is also called as the golden rice. Okay. So, what is the benefits of the fortification? It will increase the content of vitamins, okay, and because of that, you know, the work and mental capacity of the people who are consuming that will increase, and it reduces the blindness. And food fortification in India, who will carry out this? The Food Safety and Standard Authority of India, FSSAI, this is also important. This will, you know, it should give certificate to certify any food, okay, whether it is a good or not. And then here, if you see this golden rice, so golden rice is a new type of rice that contains the beta carotene. Beta carotene is a pro vitamin A. What is the meaning of that? You know, from the beta carotene, A vitamin A will be produced by using some reaction. Okay. And because of that, there is a golden color to the grain. That is why it is called as the golden rice. Okay. But what is the main disadvantage of this? Thus, it is having the low shelf life. That means when you produce the rice grain, you need to consume within the 3 months. Otherwise, it may lose its nutrients after that. Okay. And it can be grown just like the ordinary rice, okay, and there are some different types also in that. And then, you know, International Rice Research Institute, where is this? This is in the Philippines. You know, this is the nodal authority at the international level to encourage this golden rice cultivation. And in India, we have Indian Rice Research Institute. Where is that? Indian Rice Research Institute. Okay. You find out that. So, next one is the Kaleshwaram project. You know, this is executed in Telangana. It is not that much important to remember Kaleshwaram project, but here we will see different types of projects. That is important. See, here Kaleshwaram is like a lift irrigation project, lift irrigation project. Okay. So it is on the Godavari River. So here what is happening generally, how the irrigation project will be done. For example, this is the river going like that. So generally most of the rivers go from west side of India to the east side. Okay. Why it is going from west to east compared to the eastern side? West side land is a little bit on a higher side, okay, elevated. That is why rivers are going like that. When the river is going like that, then what is happening? I will choose some particular place, you know, suitable place, and then I will restrict the water by using the dam. Okay, then from this I will dug up some canals like this. Okay, these canals will go, and then the place whichever nearer to this can be irrigated. That is how it will go. And here, how the water is flowing through this canal, this is a gravity, because of the gravity. Why? Because these canals are running from a high elevated land to the low land, okay, lower elevation. That is why without using any force they are going. But in some of the cases, what happens, this river is instead of going on the surface, if it is very much deep, for example, this is the land and the river is very much deep compared to the land, then what happens? You need to lift this water and then power here, and from here you dug up some canals. You dig some canals and then here, from here it will go. That means the water, if you construct a dam also, the water is not coming up to the land level, but there is a lot of water available, but it is not coming to the land level. In that case, what happened? You will, lift this water to here. How you lift? You keep some electric pumps here so that the water can be, lifted to the surface level. That is what here lift irrigation meaning. Okay, it is a multi-purpose irrigation project. Whenever it is a multi-purpose, what is the meaning of that? Multi-purpose means it is used for the irrigation, and it is also used for the electricity generation also. How it is electricity generation here? For example, if you take, when you store the water, then what happen? It will create a lot of hydrostatic energy, and at the bottom, you keep some turbines and you release this water. So what happens? It will hit the turbine and run, and then it produce the electricity. Okay. And the same thing here explained, whatever I explained. This is a generally lift irrigation. Natural flow is like a gravity fed canal system. But in case of the lift irrigation, what is there? It requires the external electric power, using the pumps or other mechanical means. Okay, and there are two other important missions, but since it is a localized news, you may not be getting this. But here, mission Kakatiya and mission Bhagiratha. See here, mission Kakatiya is renovating all the lakes. Okay, in the entire Telangana. During the Kakatiya period, they concentrated on digging so many lakes, because of that irrigation, and then farming was very much famous in those days. Okay, so the drought, or whenever there is a drought here, if you have a lake system, then it will store the water in almost every village, then you may not face that problem. Still, there are some lakes in every village. Still, there are, lakes even in my village also. This is the mission Kakatiya, and mission Bhagiratha is, creating overhead tanks in each village near this lake, so that drinking water can be supplied to every household. That is the meaning of this. And next one is promoting the GI product. GI is geographical indications. Okay, this you no need to remember what is that, the year and all. So promotion, why need to promote this? The promotion into trade fair. Okay, promotion of a trade fair, where trade fairs will be happen, there you need to promote this, and then create awareness of GIs, so that it will increase the sales of product. What is the GA? GA is the geographical indications, like Banaras Pan is very much famous, or Tirupati Laddu is very much famous. Okay, or Lichi, okay, in particular season, especially Bihar. When I went to that place, I used to eat a lot. Bihar, I think Muzaffarabad is very much famous for Lichi. Okay, so like that, if you say Banaras Pan, people will buy more. Okay, lychee from Muzaffarabad, then people show interest, okay, because of its quality and all. So this GI product is like you need to promote the awareness in the people whoever are producing that, and also in the people consumers, so that the sales will be increased. That is the meaning of that. And also use the social media and state government and union government, to promote these things. And the importance of GA tag is, when the product is GA status, then it price increases in the international market because of its thing. Okay. And then, see, not only these, here one more important thing is like a government also looking at the retail chains, like Flipkart, Amazon, and then, you know, these are all e-commerce retail chains in the online. Apart from that, offline, okay? Like if you take, you know, Birla, more company from the Birla, Reliance Fresh, okay, you rope in those so that they also encourage these GI tag products. And then, because of that, the farmer or artisans get the legal protection from the bogus products, and then indirectly leads to sustainable development of the reefs. And always we will see GI tag and then a trademark. Okay, this is a brand of the Tata's or a brand of the Reliance, something trademark of the brand, something advertisement you may say, and sometimes GI tag. What is the difference between these two? GI tag is for the product comes from a particular place or a region, and a trade is for the particular enterprise or a company. Okay, and GI tag is enjoyed by a community, whoever living in that particular region or the community, whichever community. They all get this right, but whereas here only individual right. It is given for the goods, and it is either for the goods or services. Okay. And then this is another one. Okay. Here they launched a mobile application. What is that? Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade launched a website and a mobile application. L2 Pro, learn to protect, secure, and maximize your innovations. Okay, and presently we are undergoing the fourth type of industrial revolution. Okay, what is that? Innovation driven innovation and technology driven industries. Okay, everyone is emphasizing on innovation. So whenever you are going with innovation, this IPR also plays an important role. Many times you might have observed, other countries try to apply patent for our neem tree or yoga also. Why? Because we are not aware of this, how to commercialize this. Okay. So, most of the, most of the startups, they worry about how to taking the risk and then how to tackle the risk in the market and how to bring the investment. But they are not aware of the legal, legal thing that will protect their innovations. Okay, that comes under IPR, intellectual property right. That is why, they launch this website. You might have heard like a patent officer. That is also one type of exam, okay, one type of post, government post, okay. So, they will take care about all this. So, here under this, what is happening? It will aid the youth, innovator, and entrepreneurs and small and medium industries in understanding what is the IPR. Okay, how to protect their IPR ownership and then protect and how to utilize, commercialize effectively. Okay, so to learn that, there are some modules, available at different levels, medium, starting level, medium level and advanced level. Okay, so texts are available, videos are available, they will explain how to file the patent or the trademark or whatever intellectual property right you want to apply for. Okay, how to commercialize, everything they will explain in these modules. And once if you pass this, and they also give some certificate you understood everything and you can apply for the patent, trade, or whatever it is. Okay.